Hello everyone, welcome back to another session in Dentistry and More. Today we have a very important topic from prosthodontics, that is relining and rebasing. So the name gives a clue about the procedure, that is relining and rebasing. That is, we are either doing a small procedure or complete reconstruction of an old denture, a denture which is having fitting issues. So we are doing additional work on the existing dentures, so that is relining and rebasing. So as per GPT, the relining, it is a procedure used to resurface the tissue side of a denture with new material layer. Okay, that is, we are resurfacing the tissue side of denture, so thus producing an accurate adaptation to the denture foundation area. Since it is having the fitting issues, so we are resurfacing the tissue surface. So it is usually carried out when the fitness of the denture is compromised and it is not necessary to construct a new one. You can just reline it. Whereas rebasing, it is a laboratory process of replacing the entire denture base material on an existing processes without changing the occlusal relationship or dental arch. So it is performed for extensive tissue changes and the entire denture base is changed following impression procedure. So that is the difference between relining and rebasing. So what are the indications of relining? The first thing is poor adaptation, the adaptation problem. That is adaptation of the denture base to the ridge. Then patient with complaint of looseness or instability of denture. When patient complains the dentist about his denture's looseness or instability, following a long standing history of comfort and satisfaction with the denture foot. And maybe 3 to 6 months after the construction of immediate denture, there also we need to do the relining. Or for patients in category of geriatrics or chronically ill, so such patients also we need to do the process, that is relining, geriatric or chronic ill patients, or the affordability. Some patient might not be able to afford a new denture, so in such cases also we can just do the relining. It is not costly as creating a newer denture. So rebasing is indicated when there is loss of retention and stability. And regarding the contraindications, so this is indications, contraindications. If there is excessive ridge resorption, if there is TMJ problems, if there is any TMJ problem, and dentures with poor aesthetics, dentures with major speech problem, so aesthetic compromised dentures, dentures which create major speech problem, minor speech problem will be there definitely. And if there is any presence of osseous undercuts, so in those cases we just cannot do this process of relining or rebasing. In those cases we might need to create a new one rather than reconstructing the existing denture. So the first step of relining or rebasing is a preparation. So preparation of the tissue or preparation of the existing denture. So tissue preparation involves the oral mucosa. It should be free of any type of irritation, and the dentures that should be left out of the mouth 2 or 3 days before making the final impression. So 2 to 3 days without denture. And zero irritation. There should not be any irritation for oral mucosa, and hypertrophic tissues should be removed. The hypertrophic tissues, so removal at night and massaging the gums. So these are preparatory things we should do on the tissue. So these are the tissue preparation procedures. And now let's see what are the denture preparation procedures. So border extension should be checked properly. Border extension, and it should be corrected. Undercuts should be relieved. And occlusal disharmony is corrected by selective grinding. For occlusal disharmony. And there should be accurate posterior palatal seal establishment. So next we have the relining techniques. So relining techniques are basically classified into the direct methods and indirect methods. In indirect method, we have static and functional. Static means the occlusal dentures or the dentures are in a static position. There's no functional movements like swallowing or other lip movements. So nothing will be there. We can do it in open mouth and closed mouth way. The next in indirect method is functional, where we reproduce or simulate all the basic functional movements such as chewing, smiling, and other lip and cheek movements. So in direct method, it is also known as chairside technique. So cold cured acrylic or tissue conditioner material is used for this chairside technique, but they are not very durable. So direct relining is less time consuming. So the fitting surface of the denture is cleaned, roughened, and slightly reduced, as you see the picture here. Then the flanges are trimmed just to reduce the danger of over extension, and the undercuts are removed. Then we apply the lubricant over the polished surface to prevent the new resin material to adhere on it, and the new self-curing relining material is then mixed and applied to the fitting surface. So hope you know what is exactly the polished surface and what is the fitting surface. Fitting surface is the surface which comes in contact with the tissue, and the opposite one is polished surface. So we put lubricant over the polished surface to prevent the new resin material to adhere on it, and the new self-curing relining material is applying on the fitting surface. So the denture is inserted and the patient asked to bite gently on the denture to ensure that the occlusion is not altered by the procedure. Then the molding can be carried out, and the denture is kept in situ for about 5 minutes, after which it is removed and carefully examined. So what are the problems associated with this direct or chairside technique? The first thing is material is porous and has an unpleasant odor. Then the excess monomer, which can leaches out and may irritate the mucosa, and there will be exothermic heat which can burn the mucosa, and it has a poor color stability. And if it is not positioned correctly, it can lead to gross discrepancies. So that was about the direct method. Now we have indirect method, and indirect we have static and functional. So in static, again we have open mouth and closed mouth. Okay, now let's see what is open mouth technique, that is the indirect method. So here the dentures are used as special tray, okay, for making the final impression. We are using the denture itself as a special tray, okay, not correcting on the existing dentures. We are using it as a special tray for making the final impression. Then we keep tissue stops which are prepared in the denture using a low fusing compound to maintain the vertical dimension, occlusal plane and aesthetic position of the anterior teeth. And this tissue surface and borders of the dentures are trimmed by 1 millimeter. Then these borders are molded with grain stick compound. Then we take the final impression with the zinc oxide paste. So there will be grain stick. Our usual procedure will be carried out. Then the final impression with zinc oxide eugenol. And impression of maxillary denture is made. Then followed by mandibular and new centric relation is made using the interocclusal check methods. So this is indirect method. Okay, direct method is quite easy. We directly just trim off the surface and apply the cold cure and take impression. But this is indirect method. This is exactly like how we do our procedure. In the original preparation of dentures, we use the existing denture as a special tray. Only the primary impression step is missing here. So the special tray is made, that is our old denture. Then we put tissue stops, then the green streak compounds, then the zinc oxide eugenol, and the new centriculation is made. And finally, the interocclusal check. So that is open method, where the patient's mouth is opened, first maxilla is made, then the mandible. And the advantages are, the selective impression is made without any occlusal interferences. The operator need not worry about making jaw relation while making impression, as a separate record is made. The centriculation record is verifiable. Okay, so these are the advantages of open method, which is coming in static and indirect method. But the disadvantages are the chances of increase in vertical dimension even though tissue stops are provided. So there is vertical dimension may be increased, and high possibility of denture moving forward, and it is a very demanding and a laborious technique. It is almost as like making a new denture, and it requires more clinical and laboratory time. So that is all about the open technique. Now we have the closed technique. So how it differs from open technique? Here the difference from open technique, the closed technique, where the maxilla and mandible dentures are kept in position and taken the impression simultaneously, not one after another. So in open technique, first the maxilla will be taken, then followed by mandible, here simultaneously taking impression. That is, dentures kept used as a special tray for making the final impression. Similar procedure. Then the tissue surface and the borders of the dentures are trimmed 1 to 2 mm. Except for the posterior border of the maxillary denture. Then borders are molded with our green stick compound. Then final impression with zinc oxide eugenol. And there is no separately checking the centric relation, because it is already in a closed position. So the advantage is the less chances of increase in vertical dimension, unlike our open method, and it takes less time because we are doing it simultaneously, and chances of denture moving forward during the impression is less because both are in a closed mouth position. So there is less chances it is being forwardly placed, so vertical dimension will not be increased, it takes less time, and the chances of denture moving forward taking impression is less. But the problem is, if existing errors in centric occlusion can produce pressure points and inaccurate impression, and hydrostatic pressure in palate during impression making and packing of acrylic can still cause increase in vertical dimension. So that is also there in closed mouth technique. Because of this hydrostatic pressure in palate during the impression making and packing of acrylic can result in increased vertical dimension, and there can be inaccurate impression because of the existing errors in the centric occlusion. If already that error is there in the centric occlusion, there will be inaccurate impression will be obtained. So we finished the direct technique and the static methods of indirect technique. Next we have the indirect technique, that is the functional method. Functional method, it is simple, practical and very popular. So tissue conditioners are used as an impression material. The areas of the denture which are not to be contacted by fluid resin are painted with a lubricant. Then powder and liquid of the soft liner are mixed according to the manufacturer's instructions and allowed to polymerize in the mixing cup. Then on creamy and fluid stage, what we do is we pour the material into tissue surface, and when material flow stopped, we insert it into the patient mouth. So patient is instructed to close in centric relation, maintaining the vertical dimension, and we ask the patient to make all the active and passive movements, that is the methods of border molding, such as functional movements like swallowing, smiling, speaking, until impression reaches a more stable rubber like stage. So that is the difference between functional and static. Static such movements are not there. Here we are asking the patient to simulate the functional movements. So after removal of excess tissue conditioner, then voids are corrected with new, and we need to recall the patient. After 3 to 5 days, when the patient returns, the under extensions, denuded areas and pressure spots can be corrected by trimming or maybe added adding new material. So the material is changed periodically till the tissue returns to a state of health, and then the patient is scheduled for final impression. And a zinc oxide eugenol impression paste, or we can use a light body wash impression over the conditioning material, and we can verify it. This method is similar to the functional reline technique. So this is procedures that is done in patient's mouth. Now we have the laboratory procedure. They are lab procedure. They are the flask method, then the articulator method, flask, articulator, and the jig method. So the first method, flask method. So the relined impression is poured with dental stone. Then the master cast is poured around the impression, similar to the original master cast by beading and boxing. So the cast provides the surface against which the denture is relined by invading it in a processing flask. Then the flask is warmed to soften the impression compound before opening it to remove the impression material. Separating medium is applied on the plaster and stone mold, and heat polymerized denture based resin is packed into the mold. Then the flask is closed and clamped to ensure maintenance of occlusal vertical dimension. After processing, flask is cooled slowly and the denture is retrieved from the stone, finished and polished. This is how we perform the flask method. So this, we are familiarized with this process in our original denture construction. Is almost same as this. So here the relined impression is poured with the dental stone at first. Then the master cast is poured around the impression, similar to the original master cast. How we do? By beading and boxing. Then this cast provides a surface against which the denture is relined by invading it in the processing flask. So that is how we do flask method, whereas the articulator method. So master cast is poured, then cast not separated from the impression. A layer of plaster is arranged in platform fashion on the lower member of the articulator. As the plaster is set, the cast with relined impression is placed on the wet plaster such that the teeth penetrate the plaster surface to a depth of 2 mm as you see the picture here. Okay, here in the first picture what you see is relined denture with cast stabilized on a platform of plaster to form an index. Okay, then can see the completed mounting of relined impression with cast on in the articulator with formation of index of the denture teeth. So we are creating an index of the teeth on the plaster. Okay, this forms an index or key of the teeth, which allows the positioning of the teeth. Once the plaster sets, additional plaster is placed on the base of the cast and is mounted on the upper membrane of the articulator. When mounting sets, the articulator can be opened and the denture with impression is separated from the cast. So the denture base is waxed, cast and dentures are removed from mounting. Then we do the flasking processing with heat cured denture base acrylic resin. So that is the articulator method. The final steps are same for everything, flask and articulator method. Only thing, using an articulator we create indentation or the index of the teeth on the plaster. Whereas the jig method, jig is a device used to maintain mechanically correct positional relationship between a piece of work and a tool or between the components during assembly or alteration. This is definition given by GPT. It is a device used to maintain mechanically correct the positional relationship between a piece of work and a tool or between the components during the assembly. So first we need to seat the occlusal surface of the denture on the plaster form on lower membrane of the relining jig. Then after the stone index is made, mount the denture with the cast to the upper membrane in relined jig, similar to the articulator method. So this is almost same as the articulator method. We are creating index on the plaster, that is stone. Then open the jig, remove the teeth from the denture base and adapt the base plate, wax on the cast and wax the denture. Then after processing, replace the cured denture. Check and correct occlusion using the indentation made in the jig during the mounting of denture. So that was all about the jig method. So we were discussing the relining and rebasing process. So we had direct and indirect method. So direct method was chairside method. Indirect we had static and functional. Static we had the open mouth and closed mouth technique, and then followed by the lab procedures or lab technique, flask method, articulator method and jig method. It is very commonly asked short essay or short note in prosthodontic exam. So hope you understood the concept of relining and rebasing. So I'll come up with a new topic in dentistry and more. Thank you.